Welcome back to our YouTube channel, MM Tool Parts, the most famous tool repair guys on the internet. In our opinion, of course. On this episode of Table Saw Repairs, we're going to be converting this Powermatic 66 from three-phase power to one-phase. To do this, we'll be exchanging the motor and power switch. First, we'll go over some details, and then we'll pull the motor off and show you how a replacement's done. Introduced in 1966, the Powermatic 66 is made from heavy-duty cast iron and steel for smooth cuts and vibration-free running, making it the heaviest saw in its class. It is the only saw on the market with a one-piece cast iron box trunnion, period. That alone makes it the most sturdy saw on the market. We spoke with Powermatic, who told us that several hundred thousand of these were produced between 1966 and 2008, when it was eventually replaced by the PM2000. If you're lucky enough to get your hands on one, this is the kind of equipment you'll be passing down to your grandkids. Depending on your shop setup, it's common for these to need a power conversion from three-phase to single-phase or vice versa. A power conversion usually requires replacing the motor and switch, but you don't need to be an electrician to do this work yourself. If you think you're up for the challenge, grab your tools and follow me. All PM66 saws have the same motor configuration. Pulling the old motor out is as simple as removing these two bolts. Pull the bottom bolt first, letting the motor hang from the top. This should allow for some slack on the V-belt. Remove the belt, and then pull the motor and mounting plate free from the top bolt. At this point, we can unwire the motor from the table to make it easier to work with. Next, you'll want to take a measurement of the depth of the pulley. Whether you reuse the same pulley or get a new one, it will be helpful during reinstallation to know where to set the pulley so it stays in line with the others. Once you have taken your measurements, the pulley and mounting plate can be removed. If you're just replacing the motor, the existing switch and wiring can be used as is. But if you're converting from one or three phase power, you'll need to convert the switch and wiring as well. So at this point, we can pull the switch off the table. Now we're ready to wire the motor in. Refer to the wiring specifications for your particular motor. One thing to note, wiring it backwards will cause the blade to spin backwards. So be sure you get this step right or you'll be wiring it again. Now we're at the tricky part, wiring in the motor. If you're like me and you're new to electrical, this step might seem complicated at first, but trust me, using wiring diagrams will clear up any questions you have about which wires go where. We'll use two different diagrams, one for the switch and one for the motor. For this conversion, I'll need a switch for a 3-horsepower single-phase motor. You can see here that this switch is single-phase, and here that it's 3-horsepower. For wiring instructions, find the switch wiring diagram in your user manual. If you don't have a user manual, we posted one for the PM66 in the links below this video. At the back of the manual, you'll find the appropriate diagram for your motor. In my case, I need the 3-horsepower single-phase diagram. Follow the diagram to know which wires go where. It will also point out what gauge wiring you should be using. If you're converting from 3-phase to single-phase power like we are, the first thing you'll notice is that you have an extra red wire. 3-phase motors are wired with black, white, and red. A single-phase motor will only require the black and white leads. You can either use your existing wire or get a new wire like I did. Because I only needed a few feet, I found this 10-2 wire sold by the foot at my local hardware store. I'll connect the white wire to T1, the black wire to T3, and green or ground goes on the right side up here. Once the switch is wired, we're ready to tie into the motor. The motor wiring diagram is located on the motor itself. This motor has 5 wires, some have even more. Because we have more wires on the motor than in our power cord, the diagram points out which wires tie together. It's labeled as line A, line B, and together. Line A is usually your hot or black line. Line B would be neutral or white, and together simply means we'll tie these wires together. Now that we're wired on both ends, we can put the covers on and get the motor ready for mounting. Okay, we're halfway there. It's time to reinstall. I'll start by installing the new switch and wiring. Finish by wiring the connections on the motor and replace the cover. Next, we'll mount the motor plate, followed by the pulley. This is where your measurement comes in handy. Seat the pulley the same distance away from the mounting plate as it was on the old motor. It's time to mount the motor. Begin by hanging from the top bolt. This will allow the motor to swing left, and use this slack to reattach the belts. Once secure, remove the slack to put tension on the belts and lock the bottom bolt into place.
And that's it. Converting or replacing these motors can seem overwhelming at first. Hopefully this guide makes it clear and simple so you can get the job done and get back to what matters. All of the parts we used in this video can be found on mmtoolparts.com. We are the largest seller of Powermatic table saw motors in the world. As such, we get better prices that we pass on to you. A leader in tool repairs for over 80 years, let us help you keep your tools running like new. If you have anything to add to what we covered, or if you have any questions, chances are you're not the only one. So leave a comment for us below. And don't forget to like us, share us, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, where we have hundreds of how-to videos just like this one. Good luck with your repair. See you next time.